In this example, you're asked to determine whether 3 is an eigenvalue for that given matrix. This is a little trickier than determining whether something is an eigenvector, just because the equation that you set up, it's more than just multiplying a matrix times a vector this time. But I'll start in a similar manner here. So just thinking about what an eigenvalue is. So lambda is an eigenvalue for the matrix A if there's a non-zero vector x such that A times x is equal to lambda, where lambda is just some number, times the vector x. So we want to see if that works with the number 3. But we don't know what the eigenvector is. I mean, if 3 is an eigenvalue, what eigenvector might go with that? So I'm going to set up an equation. I've copied the matrix A here. Now we don't have a vector x, so I'm just going to put x1, x2, x3 for the entries. Oops, this is 2. For the entries of x. And so we want to see if this is equal to 3 times that vector x. Now this is going to lead you to a system of equations. And if we multiply 3 by each entry here, so this is 3x1, 3x2, 3x3. And then if we do the multiplication here on the left, and let's see, I'll have 1 times x1 plus 2 times x2 plus 2 times x3 in that first position. And then 3 times x1 minus 2 times x2, 1 times x3, so plus x3. 0 times x1 plus 1 times x2 plus 1 times x3. And so we want this to equal lambda times x, so 3x1, 3x2, 3x3. So like I said, this is going to lead us to a system of 3 equations with 3 unknowns. And we can solve that system of equations using an augmented matrix. Let me first write the system of equations, though. So I'm not going to write out every detail of this, but so you'd have this first entry equal to 3x1. And so if I subtract 3x1 from both sides of that equation, so x1 minus 3x1, so I have negative 2x1. And then the rest of it remains the same. That's a 2. And this is a 2. I'll get a new stylus soon, I promise. OK, equals 0.